What's up, everyone? It's your girl, Ari Chambers here, and welcome to the post-game play PS5 van. We have WNBA superstars that we're going to be chatting up with, but we're going to be playing some 2K as well, so let's get it. We're here with PlayStation playmaker NaLyssa Smith. She's already won a chip in college and is fighting for a WNBA championship. Am I right?
Of course.
We're about to head up the van, hop on the PS5, play some 2K. Let's get it.
What's your experience been like as a PlayStation playmaker?
Oh, it's been huge. I've been playing the PlayStation since I was like 10 years old. So to have this partnership is just like surreal, for real. And like that they even like instilled this in me, like even gave me the opportunity to like do stuff like this is huge. And my family gonna see this too. They gonna be happy. Yeah.
How do you use 2K to decompress?
I feel like gaming, it just take your mind away, like from everything. It's just fun. It's just something to do.
How is the competitiveness on 2K? Mm-hmm. How does it compare to on the court?
Sue, I feel like I might take the game more serious than like playing in real life. Yeah, everything I do, I be trying to win. So I'm super competitive when it comes to the game.
Oh man.
Nah, they fouled me. They fouled.
Oh my God. Sykes, wait, but Sykes is scanned?
She looks just like that.
Not bad.
Wild. Look, she looks dead like that. Nah, they scans is.
Oh, wow. How dope is that you can just see your team right there?
Nah, this is far. I'm not gonna lie.
I heard.
What's she here?
That you be streaming.
Yeah, I've been streaming a little bit. I really just started this year. It's different. Like,
and watching the game.
Yeah, like you get to see people's personalities too. You can really be talking to people and they can ask you questions and like talk about basketball. It's just another way to engage with fans.
What's your earliest memory of a PlayStation?
Probably the PS3. Me and my brother had got it. We used to always like play it in the basement. And I remember we was playing like GTA, but we weren't allowed to play GTA. GTA when we was young.
So you were sneaking.
We used to always sneak and play GTA.
You were born into a world where the WNBA was already existing, so you knew that you could play professional on the highest level in your home country.
Yeah.
How did that impact the way you trained to be elite?
I think it's huge. I grew up going to Silver Stars games like every Friday night, for real.
Oh, that's so fun.
Yeah, like we used to always get the little tickets off the radio because they used to give them away for free.
Uh-huh.
And so my folks used to always like, I ain't gonna lie, they always surrounded me around basketball. So just seeing like the Silver Stars and going to them games when I was younger, it like showed me like, that's really where I wanna be. And that's really where I could be, especially in the city.
Damn, turnover. Well, who was your fave growing up?
Favorite player, Candace Parker. So it'd be crazy playing against
her. I'm not like, what is it like the first time you stepped on the court against Candace?
It's gonna sound like I'm a fangirl, but like, it was really surreal. She like a genuine person. She's like, though, she don't make you like feel like you less or a rookie or anything. She was chopping it up with me during the game, cause like, I was yelling at the refs, and she was like, you too good to like yell at the refs and let them get to you. So you know when people are like mentoring you, especially someone that you idolized when you was younger, like it just means so much more.
Yeah, I'm glad that you had a nice wholesome moment like that with her. Did you have a welcome to the league moment though?
It wasn't even last year, it was this year.
Oh.
Alyssa Thomas ran into my chest so hard, bro. I wasn't even trying to take a charge, and I flew on the ground.
I was trying to get out the way. I don't know, really.
Y'all were trying to do? I was trying to get out the way.
Get out the way. Oh, yeah, Chelsea Gray, get to the rim.
You know, the league has changed so much in the past 5 years, but we have so much more to go. What do you want to see next from the WNBA?
Doing everything that we're doing now, just bigger and better. I feel like with us being a league full of women, like we need more like hair stuff, more makeup.
You don't say, because the circumference thinks it's dead. Crawl in early. I see, bruh. You bring so much style, period, but what style of play do you bring to the league?
I'm always be clapping, yelling, like hype for my teammates. Totally different person on the court than off the court.
You're already making such a great name for yourself, but when it's all said and done and they look back at the history books and it says NaLyssa Smith, what do you want it to read?
Number one rebounder in the league.
Yeah.
That's my goal right now. If everybody can score the ball, but not everybody want to rebound, so that's what I want to be great at, for real.
Okay, rapid fire.
Uh-oh.
Who has the best fashion sense in the W? Don't tell yourself.
These Nate Carrington.
Harry. Good answer. Who's the worst person to travel with?
I'm probably gonna say Queen Egbo. It'll be hot on the plane and she gonna crack a joke. Like, get serious.
Who's likely to miss their flight?
I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna say Queen again.
Who's the funniest in the locker room?
I'm gonna say Emma Cannon, for real.
Yeah.
She be having me dip.
Who talks the most trash on the court?
I'll probably say Marina.
Yeah.
She don't be saying nothing to me, though, but, like, I just be hearing her talk crazy words. Like,
who's the best dancer?
I'm gonna say Maya.
She always dancing.
Yes, you see our designated dancer.
Who has the best singing voice in the league?
Jordan Canada.
Yeah.
It.
Yeah. Okay, this PS5 question. What's the best PlayStation game to ever exist?
Black Ops 3.
Oh.
Everybody know about that one.
Thank you so much for hanging out
for
the post-gameplay PS5 band. It's real. We're gonna play the NaLyssa Smith.
Yeah. Let's do it.